Hello everyone! Since I've been using Clip Studio Paint for over a year, I'm now confident enough to bring you tutorials about it. And gladly, this time Clip Studio Paint itself is sponsoring this video, so I'm very happy to be collaborating with them to bring you my first character-related tutorial in Clip Studio Paint. Before starting, I want to point out three important principles to keep in mind when doing your line art, in order to get a nice variety in the thickness of your lines. The first point is to always draw the contour, or the outer lines of the object you're drawing, in thick lines, while keeping the inner details in thin lines like this. The second point is to shade the areas where there's extreme shading, for example these parts under the hair. And the third and last point is, if you've decided where the light source in your artwork is, then you can have the lines facing the light source be thinner than the ones on the opposite side. Making these lines thicker gives more depth to your line art. Of course, how thick you make them totally depends on your art style and preference, but I think it's good to know and keep those concepts in mind while you do your line art. Alright, let's get going. I've prepared this sketch of my two OCs, Sakura and Yuya, and I'll line this artwork while explaining how I do it. The first thing I do is, I click on this button in the layers window to change the layer's color, and reduce the opacity from here, so that I can see the sketch clearly when I draw the lines. The next thing I do is create a new vector layer from here. I'll rename this layer to line art. I always make sure to draw my line art on a vector layer because it's so easy to adjust and there wouldn't be any loss in quality if you do any kind of transformation, as you'll see later. You can use any tool you like for your line art, whether an inking pen, a pencil, a brush, it's totally up to your preference. My current favorite tool right now is the darker pencil tool, however, I've modified its settings a little bit to match my preferences. In case you'd like to use my brush as well, I've left you a download link for it in the description box. Now when you start lining, don't press too hard on your pen, otherwise your lines will come out stiff and wonky. Instead, keep your strokes quick and light. If you have a screenless tablet and you feel that the surface is too slippery, then you can grab a printer paper and place it on the tablet's surface to get some sort of friction. This would help a lot in stabilizing your pen and drawing more accurate strokes. So let's start. Using darker pencil and a dark violet color, I'm gonna start lining my artwork. There is no specific brush size I go for. I literally just pick a brush size that's close in thickness to my sketch lines. For this artwork, it's 10 pixels. I'm drawing on a cropped A4 size with a 350 dpi resolution, by the way. When doing the lines, I keep my hand on Ctrl and Z to undo easily when I don't like the strokes I made. You don't need to be so zoomed in when you're doing your lines, because that will make you fret over the smallest details and will also require you to do bigger hand movements. Working a little zoomed out helps you see the big picture and do smaller hand movement on the tablet. Now since I drew the outer lines of this part with this thickness, I'll reduce the brush size to 6 pixels and draw the inner lines. Sometimes rotating the canvas really helps in getting your strokes right. I placed shortcuts for rotating the canvas over here in the command bar to make it easy for me, but they're also available in the navigator window over here. I talked about how I set my command bar shortcuts in my How I Switched to Clip Studio Paint video, so you can check it out to know how I did it. The cool thing in vector layers is that you can adjust your lines easily. For example, I don't like the curved direction of this line, I want it to be more like this. I can of course redraw it and erase the extras, but what I can also do is go to this Correct Line tool over here. There are so many adjustment options that I can make use of. One option is by using the Redraw Vector Line tool. You just go over your line and redraw it, though it's not always an easy and straightforward fix. The other option is using the Object tool, which is usually here, but I put it down here. Clicking on the line while on the Object tool shows all the control points, so you can just drag them to the positions that you want, so it's a nice quick fix. One other really convenient feature in vector layers is using the vector eraser to quickly erase crossing lines. For example, I have these two parts that I want to clean. I'll click on the eraser tool. There is already a default vector eraser tool, however, I created my own one, basically just by duplicating the hard eraser tool, then ticking vector eraser here. Now with the vector eraser, I can easily erase any intersecting lines. Sometimes when making big curves, the shakiness of your hand can get in the way of making a clean line. In those cases, I found that increasing the stabilization to a higher number and drawing the curve slowly helps get it right. This is easier to do on a screen tablet since you see your hand's position, but it's still not impossible to do it on a screenless one. You just need to give it a number of tries like I just did. I'm drawing on a screenless tablet, by the way, and I just succeeded after multiple trials. For this part of the hair, I'm gonna draw the upper curve on a new vector layer, then I'll duplicate it and drag it down while holding shift. I'll rotate it a little bit, and using the lasso tool, I'll select this part and drag it up here and rotate it slightly. Then I'll use the object tool and quickly fix some parts by moving the control points. I'll merge those two layers for this hair part so that I have it on one layer. However, I can see that I drew this part too thick in comparison to the other lines. But no worries, I can quickly fix it. I'll go to the correct line tool again, then choose correct line width and choose narrow. You can set how narrower you want to go to from this number. I'll go for 0.9. This tool is like a brush. You brush over the lines you want to adjust, and as you see, it's easily getting adjusted and becoming thinner. I'll speed up the video now because I'll keep repeating the same steps over and over, and we'll slow it down when I have new tips to introduce. I usually like to draw the face lines on a separate layer, so I created a new layer and named it Sakura's face to draw her face on. If you feel something is awkward, you can always select the part you want to edit and transform it. For example, I want to adjust the eye here, so I'll select it with the lasso tool, then hit Ctrl plus T, then hold the Ctrl key to activate free transformation, and drag the corners I want to adjust. Since this face is a front view, the eyes are symmetric, so to save time, I'll duplicate the eye I've just drawn, hit Ctrl plus T, flip it horizontally from this button, then rotate it and drag it to its correct position. One other cool line adjustment feature is the Pinch Vector Line tool. So I want to adjust the curvature of her upper lip, but this pinch is too narrow, so I'll increase the pinch level from here and drag the part I want to fix. I can also fix any other lines easily with this tool, in addition to all the ones I've mentioned earlier. I felt the sketch color was uncomfortable for my eyes, so I changed it by clicking on the sketch layer, then under Layer Property, I'll just change it from here. I went for light pink since it's easier on my eyes. If you don't see this, just go to Window, Layer Property to enable it. Now I want to start lining Yuya, the second character that is in front of Sakura. To make the two characters distinguishable from each other, I'll draw the outlines of Yuya that are in front of Sakura to be thicker. Then for the rest of the lines, I'll continue doing everything I did with Sakura. When you want to draw geometric shapes cleanly, you can click on the Figure tool over here. I want to draw the circular shirt buttons for example, so I'll choose the ellipse tool and change the brush size to 7, then draw the circle while holding shift, and then using the object tool, I'll adjust its position. I'll copy it for the second button too. To make the circle look more like a hand-drawn one, we can use the correct line width tool to vary its thickness. I made the upper side thinner here, and now the circles look less stiff and give more of a hand-drawn feel. If there's any line that you don't like, you can use the object tool to select it, then hit the delete button to delete it, and redraw it as you like. For Yuya's face, I essentially did the same steps I did earlier, except that for the sparkle in his eye, I drew the upper part first, then copied it and flipped it to have a clean looking result, then placed it on his eye. I also copied his eye, since it's also symmetric here, and continued drawing the face. Now, for lining the book, we can of course freehand it, but using the figure tool would make it look neater, so I'll create a new vector layer and draw one side of the book, then duplicate it. First, I'll use the straight line tool with a brush size of 5 and draw this side. Then I'll use the continuous curve tool with the same brush size and gently draw the curve of the book. You can quickly adjust the lines by holding the control key and dragging the points. To give the book cover some thickness, I'll duplicate it and move it up, then connect this side. I'll do the same thing for the pages, then duplicate this half book and flip it to get the full book. I'll add some details with thinner lines inside. And finally, I'll vary the thickness of the book, then erase the intersecting lines. As for this pearl necklace, I can freehand it or use the circle tool to draw it pearl by pearl, but the easiest method is just to create a brush and use it to quickly draw the necklace. For that, I'll create a new vector layer, draw a circle outline, I'll select the circle with the object tool and change the brush size from here. Then I'll vary the thickness of the lines by narrowing, for example, the top side and thickening the bottom side. You can zoom out your canvas to see how the shape would look like as a small brush. I think I need to thicken it a little bit more by increasing the brush size. Now that it's ready, I'll rasterize this layer by right-clicking and choosing Rasterize. Then go to Edit, Register Material, Image. I'll call it Pearl Outline. And tick the Use for Brush Tip Shape here, and choose a location. I'm gonna save it under Image Materials, Brush. Now go to the Decoration Brushes and go to the Ruled Line Set. Scroll down till you see this dotted line brush. You want to duplicate this and rename it. I'll call it Pearl Outlines. And you're gonna go to the brush settings over here and go to brush tip, choose material, and click over here, add brush tip shape. Then you can type the name of the image you just saved. I'll type Pearl Outline and double click to choose it. So now I have this shape as a brush already, but what I'm gonna do is I'll go to brush size, click over here, and tick pen pressure to activate size variation. You can go to any minimum size you prefer. I think that 50% is good enough to give me the result I want. Now the pearl size changes with pen pressure. So I'll go back to the line art, make a new vector layer, and use this brush to draw the necklace outlines. I press lightly at the edge, increase the pressure at the center, and decrease it again at the other edge. So this way, we've effortlessly drawn the pearl necklace outlines. I'll erase the overlapping lines with a normal eraser, since erasing them with a vector eraser was ruining them. But what I would eventually do is, I would skip drawing the outlines of the pearl altogether, and add it later in the coloring phase, because I created a completely colored pearl brush. I made it exactly using the same steps, except that the image material I used is a pearl I painted. We're almost done with this line art. I'll just give it some final adjustments. First, shading the corners like I mentioned at the start of the video, then thickening some of the lines that are in the shaded direction. Now, one last tip. Let's say I want to erase the lines of this other necklace, but without losing them completely. I can do that by adding a layer mask. I'll select the line art layer, then click on this button over here to create a layer mask, then erase those parts that I don't want. The great thing about erasing while on a layer mask is that you can hide it anytime by right-clicking on the layer and unticking enable mask. And as you can see, what I just erased wasn't completely erased, but rather, it was hidden. And that's why this is also called non-destructive erasing. So, the line art is complete now, and we have finally reached the end of this tutorial video. I truly hope you found this helpful. And if you did, don't forget to share it with other people who could benefit from it. It will help me a lot so that I can make more videos like this. Thanks for watching.